animals finally recognized the death wagon from Mr. Whimper's glue factory.
Was sold to a glue factory. Our beloved leader would never do that. Long live Napoleon! Long live Napoleon!
And that night, the pigs drank to Boxer's memory in the whiskey they had bought with Boxer's life. Years passed. The seasons came and went. The short animal lives fled by. The completed windmill stood as a monument to its builder's faith and sacrifice. But the animals' revolution was only dimly remembered. Outwardly, Animal Farm appeared prosperous. But the animals themselves were no better off, with the exception of the pigs and their supreme leader, Napoleon. Pig-run enterprise now had many of the frills of real civilization. And one fine day, pig delegates from far and wide arrived at Animal Farm to celebrate the coming of a new era. Reports of this great change reached them. Other animals everywhere were incredulous. Dismayed and indignant, they headed toward Animal Farm from all directions, instinctively uniting once again in common cause.
followers. On farms owned and operated by pigs, there is order and discipline. Our lower animals do more work and eat less than on other farms. This will encourage you to make your lower animals work even harder and eat even less. This greater animal farm, to peace and plenty under pig rule. To the day when pigs own and operate farms everywhere.
To the animals, it now seemed that their world, which may or may not someday become a happy place to live in, was worse than ever for ordinary creatures. And another moment had come when they must do something about it.